2 days on, the big banks still show no sign of passing on the full interest rate cut, and their standoff with the government has intensified. More details, we're joined in Canberra by political reporter Amanda Hart. Good morning, Amanda. Now, is there any more that the government can do at this stage?
Well, Tash, it's certainly been doing a lot of huffing and puffing, but at this stage, there really isn't anything more the government can do. Its hands are pretty much tied. Now, the big four banks are still umming and ahhing about whether or not they're going to pass on Tuesday's interest rate cut, just a little bit, the full cut, or at all. Now, it's citing increased borrowing costs, basically because of the debt crisis in Europe, for why they might not pass it on. Analysts are warning, look, it's been 2 days now. If the banks haven't moved by now, it's pretty unlikely that they're going to. They're headed The Bankers Association has conceded that may be the case, but has denied that the big banks are being greedy while homeowners are doing it tough. Now, Treasurer Wayne Swan was out and about this morning. He's been shaking his fist at the banks, saying that the government has done a number of things to make the banking industry more competitive, and banks really should be ashamed of their behaviour at the moment. Take a listen.
I don't think there's any excuse for the banks not passing on this rate cut in full, and I think virtually every minute that they delay, many of their customers will be sitting back and thinking, well, I might just give them the boot.
And Amanda, in other political news today, pressure certainly growing on the government to introduce a Medicare-style dental scheme.
Yeah, Tash, that pressure is mainly coming from the Greens, and that's because when the government was negotiating to form government, it made a promise to them saying, look, yes, we will look at a Medicare-style dental scheme. Now, the government has received a report which backs that up, but it's not going to be releasing it because apparently it's an interim report. The Greens do have a copy of that report, though, and say that it shows that millions of Australians are unable to access adequate dental care because of the cost. Apparently, this report also says that we need to be looking at low-income earners, people in regional areas, and children as well. The report also apparently says we need to put a whole lot of money into the next budget to try to fund such a scheme or start looking at it, and the money is just going to need to increase in subsequent budgets. The question is, of course, how is it going to be paid for? Well, let's have a listen to the Greens' take on it.
75% of the Australian community have said they would support an additional Medicare levy to fund dental care. It's a huge issue, huge demand in the community, particularly if you're a low-income earner and young kids.
The Greens also want proceeds from a beefed-up mining tax to go towards such a scheme, Tash.
Amanda Hart reporting from Canberra. Thank you.